Welcome to Sir Win's Accounting Lectures. Today, magkakaroon tayo ng pen and paper video problem solving patungkol sa Lecture 02, Trade and Cash Discounts. Actually, nasa description ng video lecture na ito yung mismong problem under discussion. Kung gusto mong sagutan ng solo at balikan ang lecture na ito kapag tapos ka na, mas mabuti. Kasi ang accounting ay natututunan not by mere listening but actually by you doing the problem solving. Pero kung may sagot ka na nga, simulan na natin. So again, Lecture 02, Trade and Cash Discount. So here is our problem. On March 1, 2021, Wendy Cortez Wish Enterprise sold merchandise with a 250,000 list price. Okay, so actually meron tayo ditong 5 different cases. Sabi dito, for each of the sales term, determine the following. Number 1, the amount recorded as sales. And number 2, the amount of cash received. So ibig sabihin, sasagutan natin yung problem one by one, depende sa magkakaibang cases. Okay? Simulan na natin sa case A. Ang sabi dito, the list price is 250,000. Basically, hindi pa siya yung ire-record mo na sales. Kasi kung sakaling merong trade discount, ibinabawas yun para ma-determine yung amount of sales. Kasi yung invoice price, yung net of trade discount, ang nare-record sa account title na sales kung sakaling ikaw yung seller. In this case, tayo yun. Okay, so sagutan na po natin. The list price is amounting to 250,000. Pero meron trade discount na basically 30% of this one. So gumamit tayo ng calculator para ma-determine yun. Okay, so that would be 250,000 times 0.3. Okay, 30%. So that would be 75,000. Okay, pag minus natin yun, so basically yun yung mararecord natin na amount of sales. So multiply, okay, sorry, deduct. 250,000 minus 75,000. So we will get 175,000. That will be answer to number 1. Okay? How much will be the cash received? So ang assumption kasi dito, merong credit terms. So ayun, sabi, 210 in 30. At nagkaroon nga ng transaction nung March 1 at binayaran siya nung March 9. So basically, ang difference, March 1 going to March 9, hindi pa siya lalampas ng 10 days. Kasi ang ika-10th day ay March 11. So you remember how to count? Okay? Exclude the first day, include the last day. So ang bilang ay mula March 2. March 2 going to March 11 is 10 days. The fact na March 9 pa lang nagbabayad, pasok pa siya dun sa discount period. Okay? So therefore, we have to deduct the cash discount. Okay? The cash discount is basically 2%. Okay? 2% ng ano? Ng recorded sales sa 175,000. Now we compute for that. 175,000 times 0.02 is 3,500. So 3,500 will be our cash discount. So when we deduct, okay, that will be the cash received. Ayan. So therefore, 175,000 minus 3,500, so we will get 171,500. Okay, so that's it. That's answer to number 2. Again, 1 and 2. Punta na tayo sa second scenario, case B. Ang sabi dito, okay, merong 40% trade discount. Terms is 110 and 30. Date paid is March 22. So how much is the list price? Okay? Siyempre, hindi naman nabago yung problem. That is still 250,000. Alam mo na mayroon trade discount. Okay? Na basically, 40% ng 250,000. 250,000 times 0.40. So we will get 100,000. When we deduct, okay, 250,000 minus 100,000, we will get the sales. Okay, this is the amount to be recorded as sales. Okay? Ngayon, meron tayong credit terms nga na 110. Nga lang nagbayad siya March 22. Hindi pa naman siya lampas ng 30 days kasi nga ang 30th day nito ay March 31. Okay, 22 siya nagbayad. Pero ang punto, nalampasan siya ng discount period. That's why there is no discount. Okay? Whatever is the sale will be the cash received. So therefore, this will be our final answer for number 1 and number 2. So, ganyan na lang pong ating presentation. Okay? Now, let's move on with case C. Okay? Ang sabi sa case C, there is no trade discount. Okay? So, the credit terms is 210 and 30. So, March 10 binayaran. Okay? Gawin na po natin. Sa case C naman, okay? Dahil walang trade discount, basically, the sales price, okay, or the sales, okay, is the same, 250,000. That will be answer to number 1 immediately. Ngayon ang kasunod na tanong, pumasok ba siya dun sa discount period? The answer is yes, kasi nga binayaran niya ay March 10. So therefore, pasok pa siya dun sa cash discount. So i-deduct natin yung cash discount. Okay? So 2% of 250,000. At the answer would be 5,000. So pag dineduct natin siya, therefore lalabas yung cash received. Ayan, which will be our answer. So ipakita ulit natin, 250,000 minus 5,000. So that would be 245,000. That would be answer to number 2. Okay. Next, punta na agad tayo sa case D. Case D, ang sabi dito, okay, 25,10 ang trade discount, 210 and 30 ang credit terms, March 7 binayaran. Ang ibig sabihin ng ganitong description or parang presentation sa trade discount, nag-discount muna ng 25%. Then later on, nag-discount na naman ng 10%. So dalawang beses na nangyari yun, yung pag-discount. At pwede po siya. Okay? Sagutan na natin. The list price is 250,000. Okay? The first trade discount is what? 25%. So therefore, 250,000 times 0.25, okay, hindi po yung calculator, times 0.25, so 62,500. Ayan, so then ating i-deduct siya. Okay, so 250,000 minus 62,500, so we will get, okay, 187,500. And we will call it balance. Okay, kumbaga tumawad, dyan muna nakapunta. And then afterwards, tumawad na naman, second, trade discount. Okay, 10%, 10% of which is 18,750. So dalawang beses siyang tumawad. So now, how much would be, okay, the amount of sales. Okay, so 187,500, the balance, less the second trade discount. So we will get 168,750. Na basically, that would be the amount of sales. Okay, answer to number 1. Ngayon, ang kasunod na tanong, pumasok ba siya dun sa discount period? The answer is yes. Kasi March 7 pa lang nagbayad. March 7 pa lang, bayad na siya. Therefore, we put here the cash discount. Okay? The cash discount is 2% of sales. So therefore, 168,750 times 0.02. Okay? So that would be 3,375. And then when we deduct, that would be the cash received. Ayan. So therefore, 168,750 minus 3,375, we will get 165,375. That will be our cash received. So, ganun yung concept nun. Okay, now let's try to move on with the last case. Okay? 20% and 20%, 210, 115, and 45, March 13. So, basically, alam na po natin ito. Okay? Ngayon, pagdating dito sa credit terms, ang ibig sabihin nito, meron kang discount na 2% within 10 days. Okay? Kung sakali namang ika-11, kasi nga 10 na tapos, ika-11th day hanggang ika-15th day, bibigyan ka ng 1% discount. Okay, pero yung original term, credit period, is hanggang 45 days. Okay, sasagutan na natin yung case E para mas ma-appreciate. Ayan. Okay, case E. our list price is still 250,000. At ang sabi, merong first trade discount, okay, which is 20%. Yan. So 250,000 times 0.2, so we will get 50,000. Okay? And then we will get the balance. Okay, so 250,000 minus 50,000, so we will get 200,000. Then afterwards, there is a second trade discount. The second trade discount is 20% ng bagong balance. So that would be 40,000. And then we deduct, that would be the sales to be recorded. Okay, so 200,000 minus 40,000, so we will get 160,000. Basically, that is answer to number 1. Okay? And then later on, March 13, nagbayad. Okay, pasok ba siya dun sa 10 days? The answer is no. Kasi ang ika-10th day nga ay March 11. Okay, therefore, ang March 13 ay ika-12 days. Okay? So, pasok siya dito sa 15, di ba? Therefore, meron pa din namang cash discount. So, therefore, we write cash discount. Nga lang, hindi na 2% yung rate na gagamitin, but rather 1%. So, times 0.01. So, that would be 1,600. So, then we deduct. Then after that, we solve. So we will get the cash received. Ayan. So 160,000 minus 1,600. So 158,400. That will be answer to question number 2. Okay? Actually, itong mga to, ginagawa lang natin siya para mag-present ng computation. Pero in reality, in problem solving, okay, ginagawan talaga to ng journal entries. Pero hindi pa po yun ngayon. Magkakaroon din naman tayo ng illustration patungkol sa may mga discount na nagjo-journal din. Okay? So sa ngayon, tapos na po tayo. So yun lamang at maraming salamat.